Hello, my name is Jay, and welcome back to my Tech Vault. Today we're going to talk about a topic that doesn't get brought up too often, and I really think it should, because I think it needs to be addressed, and it's kind of important it does. So, chances are the device you're watching this video on right now has a back door that, if accessed, pretty much gives anyone full access to all your device, the passwords, whatever YouTube account you have on here, any personal information that you have on there. And it's not just this device, it's your computer, your tablets, anything that was made by Intel or AMD from the last 8 to 10 years. So think about that for a second. Most common devices have a big back door in them. And this isn't just like a back door that someone found. This is a back door purposely put there by these companies that manufacture stuff, or these processors. And you're going, well, that's kind of an interesting way to look at it. Well, not only does a back door, of course, give, you know, elevated privileges, but the worst part is there's no way you can really stop it. Intel, in particular, calls this the Intel Management Engine. And AMD calls it the security engine, I believe. And both of these work in similar ways. They have the processor itself, the actual die, and then there is a microprocessor, another little processor, that runs between the die itself and the rest of the computer. And so this little thing allows pretty much interception of any data that comes through it, so full backdoor access. And you can kind of sit there and you can't turn it off whatsoever. At least you, the consumer, can. So you have this little back door that both AMD and Intel processors both have. Similar, but different. Sorry, fanboys, you guys can't bicker in the comments. It's pretty much even. And this is a black box that you have no clue what goes on inside. Intel advertises it as having essential functions to turn on and off your computer. It's important to start up the processor. Without it, it would ruin, you know, or be impossible to boot it up. Now, we're going to take a look at a couple things. First off, for, in particular, government agencies, Intel has a way to turn off this microprocessor, or this little chip. Now, what's the concern with, why would government agencies want this chip off? Well, it's kind of a big back door. Also, some people have figured out, and I'm talking about Intel because this is what I did a lot of reading on, AMD has similar issues. I'm not just talking about AMD. AMD has their own issues. Please check in those two. They're both pretty even. So there have been people that have figured out ways to modify or turn off this management engine, and it's actually worked pretty good. You can't completely wipe it because at some point, I would think that they, if they wanted to keep it there, they would have to have some important function, to, otherwise it shut off the processor. Also, some people have done some good job by completely wiping the code on the chip and then ended up completely bricking their CPU, which who would have thought that there is technically kind of like BIOS level code on a CPU. Now, really the problem though is that no one really knows what the software is. It's software that runs, but you have no idea what it is. It runs behind closed doors. You'll never really know what's going on, and pretty much it has as much access as you'd like, or anybody would like. Now, really, who has back doors? Both AMD and Intel. And Intel would like to tell everybody, and this is, I believe, somewhat on the general gist of what they said, is that they said that they don't install back doors in their products. Well, I mean, I could think of a multitude of reasons why back doors would be installed. Government agencies wanting access. Government agencies wanting access to stuff. Government agencies, just pretty much, there's a few things that people would want to know, especially after some of the events in the United States after the 9/11 incident. There was a lot of laws passed that allowed the government to go through and do a little bit more invasive stuff in cyber protection. I'm not going to comment on like the morals of that. That's just what happened. So the raises the question is, these security vulnerabilities, they're pretty big, and they could run into issues. And there has been a lot of other known security issues with it that have ended up elevating privileges in a system. So the question to really ask is this vulnerability something you want to pay extra for? Well, you really don't have a choice. It's in all of modern processors from AMD and Intel, and I'm sure we'll find out soon that some other chip company, as they start to get bigger, has the same issues. So really what it comes down to is just be aware of what you're buying, because hopefully you're not doing anything too bad that the back door gets used on you. But thank you guys very much for watching. Have a wonderful day. And of course, check out the channel for other cool tech-related news, reviews, builds, etc. See you later. Goodbye.